I'm gonna show you some magic. It's the real thing.
I genuinely love the process of manipulating people online for money.
If humans are already tricked by, you know, simple spam emails, I think deepfakes are gonna be really effective in the future if there aren't tools in place against them. There was a project called the Video Rewrite Program, and that was the first major application of a deepfake. So you could take one person talking in a video track and sync it to a different audio track and, you know, manipulate their face to make it seem like they're talking from the other audio track.
I never met Forrest Gump. I'm a little teapot, short and stout.
The term deepfake comes from deep learning mixed with fake event. So the fake event is the, you know, output of what a deepfake comes up with. And then deep learning is the process to come up with the algorithms and everything to, you know, combine the image with the video. You can take an image and apply it to a video of somebody moving their face.
What's up, TikTok?
Every now and then I like to treat myself.
Deep Tom Cruise, if that was used for malicious purposes, you know, you could use a platform like TikTok to go viral and spread, you know, pretty dangerous news. As a human, if we pull up a video of someone and if the voices sound similar enough, I feel like the image of the you know, the deepfake will kind of trick the ears into, like, you know, being like, oh, hey, that's that person's voice. And, you know, there are pretty good voice actors who can almost replicate the real thing. It's bringing deepfakes to the masses in a way that hasn't really been seen before. I think by being able to take, like, for example, like an old deceased family member, taking one of their pictures and kind of, you know, turning them back into life, that could be a really cool experience for a lot of people.
Oh my God.
Taking a world leader and making a deepfake out of them, and basically they could, you know, say whatever they want. They could say things to cause public unrest, you know, say, like, I guess, give dangerous information or dangerous, I guess, like, commands, you know, to people. You know, family members can be impersonated, so scams can happen that way as well. I'd say, like, 10 years ago when text was the biggest thing, text and images, it wasn't nearly as big of an issue. But now, you know, I already feel like the shorter form video platforms already have a huge, like, misinformation issue and fake news issue because video is so convincing. I'm sure, like, hackers are going to get much more creative about this stuff, especially going forward. But I think big tech is going to be banding together and focusing on tools that can help prevent deepfakes, or at least catch them right away, and probably, like, provide labels to say, hey, this, like, you know, isn't good, especially, you know, on Facebook, Instagram, TikTok, any of these apps. Social media companies are the ones that need to be focusing on creating these tools, I think, at the forefront of all of this, because they're the ones who'd be most heavily impacted, and their users as well.